Today on the IoT show, I want to show you something really cool.
How can I help you?
Can you tell me a joke?
What are the top two priorities of restrooms? Simple, number one and number two.
Okay, I was not expecting that joke. It's pretty cool. This device here is part of a project called Garcon that some team at Microsoft is working on. Ganesh is here to represent the team and will tell us a bit about how we're making buildings smarter across the campus at Microsoft. Hi everyone, this is Olivier. You're watching the IoT show. Thanks for watching. We are in building 18 today. I'm with Ganesh. Ganesh, how are you?
Hi, I'm doing good.
Good. So, Ganesh, you're part of the Microsoft IT team. So what kind of team are you working with and what are you doing?
Yeah. I'm part of real estate and facilities engineering team.
Okay.
We are working on a lot of services and applications that provides experiences to employees.
Okay.
One of our core priorities is to build a smart workspace.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, as we're talking about digital twins and making spaces smart and combining IoT with AI to actually achieve all of that, we actually here have a device. Mm-hmm. Looks like nothing right now, right? You need to have a sign to tell people to like talk to it. You're going to talk to us a little bit about that. Where does the idea come from, for that device here? What is the need? What is it they're trying to do here? Having people talking to a wall in a building, how's that useful?
So one of the things, actually it all started with, how can we go create a ticket quickly when there is an issue, how do we report that? Usually there is a web portal, user comes in, he uses the restroom, when he walks back to his desk, right? So he doesn't find time to go log into a portal, do a lot of stuff out there. That's where this idea came in, where we can have a device just right in front of wherever we have to go create a ticket, swipe his badge to identify his identity, and then go take actions based on what he needs.
Got it.
So that's the base.
And actually, because it's an IoT device, you can put many of these all over the place. So you don't have to go to a specific place to actually report the problem, right?
Precisely, yeah.
So in that case here, what's the name of the project?
It's Garcon.
Garcon, okay. Mm-hmm. And so basically like in a cafe, it's like, hey, Garcon, please bring me something.
Yeah,
right?
Exactly, something like that.
So obviously people are intrigued here to see that. Mm-hmm. Sometimes they think it's fake, like in these airport bathroom where you press, the little smiley face to say how satisfied you are. Yeah. You have to show us how real that is, right?
Exactly.
No, go ahead, right?
All right. So let me, what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how you can, there's a lot of functionalities within this.
Yeah.
One of it is what is, creating a ticket, wherein, you swipe your badge and you say something like this.
How can I help you?
There's a water spill. Can you create a ticket to clean it?
Thank you. We have made a note of your ticket.
Exactly. Okay. So there is a workflow behind this. What happens is this will trigger an email to our CMMS, CRM system.
Okay.
They will actually take care of this, and there will be a person who would walk in and, they will go ahead and clean that. Now, you might have a question on, how do they know the location?
Yeah.
The device has all of it configured, and it would have, the ticket it creates, it has all the data that they need to identify where exactly the water spill is.
Okay. And voice recognition and all that happen here on the device or happen somewhere else?
So voice gets translated into text on the device.
Okay.
However, the remaining processing of, what is the intent and all that happens on the cloud.
Okay,
so a good
mix of the thing can transform into text what I'm telling it. It knows who I am because I badged.
Exactly.
Send upstream, and then you have a system that actually can evolve in terms of capabilities, right? Because you were saying there's limited some set of capabilities.
Mm-hmm.
So typically, when I walk out of room of a meeting room, or I'm in front of a room, I may want to book that room for a meeting, or I want eventually to book a shuttle to go to another building. So these are all capabilities we expect to have on this solution.
Yes, exactly. So those are the capabilities that we want to build within it. One of the other thing that we have is, let's say it's lunchtime and you are heading towards going to one of the cafes and you want to know what is available.
Okay.
You can actually swipe in.
How can I help you?
Where can I find sushi?
Cafe 50 has 4 stations and some of the menus are House of Yoshi, House of Yoshi, and Typhoon/Hoi. For more menu items and menu descriptions, Please visit Microsoft Campus Link app. Thank you.
If you would have noticed, so it's not only about, you know, giving you information, it's also about connecting multiple applications. Campus Link, I'm sure you would have installed, or
that
is also another application my app, my team works on.
Mm-hmm.
Basically building a connected experience and, you know, giving a seamless experience for the user. It's not like, you know, there's one device which does certain things and you have an app which does certain other things, but it's about connecting these two things together. And in fact, you know, when this says this, when the user opens up his application, those notifications will automatically pop up in his app on mobile phone. So that's the experience that they are.
And actually, the other thing which is really interesting is the choice of menu actually comes from the cafes that are managed by some vendors, right?
Exactly.
And so basically, you're starting to gather data from the people, right? I'm walking, I'm here, the device, the location of the device, what you can understand from people, and then third-party data as well. What is the menu today coming from another vendor? So you're combining all that data in the cloud in the form of digital twins, model all of that, and allow people to actually navigate that data very seamlessly here.
Exactly, yeah.
Awesome. That's a very good demo, Ganesh. Looking forward to more of these.
Sure.
And we expect to have these devices all across our campus. So when you visit us on campus, don't hesitate. Like, ask someone to badge it, talk to it, ask for a joke or something, or ask for directions, money, and so on. I hope to see you soon on the IT show again. Don't forget to subscribe.
Thank you.